Hi everyone, today's video is going to be my July favorites. I also have unfavorites and a couple products I'm confused about. I do have lifestyle and fashion favorites as well, and empties at the end. Let's get into the beauty products. The first beauty products I want to talk about are makeup products, and the first one is the Essence Prime Plus Studio Redness Correcting and Pore Minimizing Primer. I don't remember what videos I mentioned this in, but I will link videos and product links in the description box, so check that out. The reason I love this primer is because it's actually pretty moisturizing. I had to switch from my last primer because that was way too drying for my skin, and this actually does really help with calming down redness. In a primer, that's something that I look for because it reminds me so much of the Cover Effects calming primer that they don't make anymore. So I'm really glad that I have this. I use this for both my under eyes and my spots. The next makeup product is my Benefit Hoola bronzer. I have been using the crap out of this bronzer for the entire summer, and I still do use it even though in Europe the weather is kind of like really crappy. It's like fall weather basically. It's like the perfect color to make you look tan, and I hit pan on it a couple days ago. I was so surprised. I opened it up, I used my brush, and boom, the little pan showed up here. You already know how difficult it is to go through powders if you're not using it every day, or if you're just using it in certain areas. For me, I never thought that I would ever go through another bronzer, and I think in my entire life I've never gone through one until now. So I definitely recommend picking up this bronzer because it's just the perfect color. It's not muddy. It's very easy to blend as well. I did a video on what is in my travel makeup bag or makeup train case, and I did use this in that video if you want to see me use this. Along with the bronzer, my favorite brush of the month, actually the past 2 months. By the way, I'm really sorry about how late this favorites video went up. I am not really that late with favorites, just this time I took a break. But anyways, I really like this brush because it's dual-sided. I got this so many years ago at CVS when they still had Essence of Beauty brushes. On one end has a fluffy brush that I love to use for powder, so for face powder, and the other one is a fluffy angled brush that I like to use for contouring my nose. So I do use the Benefit Hoola bronzer. So what I do with the brush is I just tap it in the powder. I don't even shake off the powder because I want like a really crazy bold line there. And then I just use the other side of the brush with my face powder to blend it out. I do have a video on how I contour my nose with powder, and that video is about my comparing 5 nose contour brushes that I got from the drugstore. The next makeup product is the Mali Dark Circle Corrector, and wow, I didn't expect to like this so much. It really does brighten up the under eyes, and it's so lightweight. When I don't have too bad of allergies, when my under eyes are kind of dry and they don't want like regular concealer, I will use this corrector and it's just fine. But I have been sneezing a heck ton. I have been blowing my nails a lot, and this works really well under any other concealer that I have. And my favorite under eye concealer is the It Cosmetics one. I believe it is in just one color. It says the shade is deeper. I will link it in the description box. I hope they have it back in stock, because the past 2 months when I tried to link it in my videos, it said unavailable. And I got this on QVC in a pack of 2. It has a sponge tip applicator, and all you do is just twist up the product and it'll come out. The last makeup product is this beautiful peach blush. This is the Essence Matte Touch Blush in 10, Peach Me Up. I didn't expect to like this either because I love the NARS blushes, but I just don't want to support NARS anymore. And this is so much cheaper and it's so pigmented. This is a matte blush that still gives the face quite a bit of a glow. I do have it on my face today and I just love it. It's so easy to blend as well. I go pretty heavy on my blushes just because I like that cute doll look. I apply it to this area and then just blend it out a little bit here. I notice that when I work out, my whole face turns red, but I notice that when I work out, I do tend to get really red over here, so that's exactly where I put the blush so it looks the most natural. I love to use this for any look that I'm going for just because peach looks the best on my skin tone and it just matches all of my makeup looks. Moving on to skincare, I really enjoyed using the Garnier Skin Active Micellar Cleansing Water. This is the all-in-one waterproof one. I know I've been knocking it in my skincare videos or my favorites videos just because this is not the micellar cleansing water that I prefer to use all over my face as a morning cleanse. That's actually the pink cap one, but this one is basically specifically made for removing waterproof makeup, and I actually really do like it. I brought this with me to our one week trip to Amsterdam, and it just took off my makeup so easily. And this is a fraction of the price of my favorite eye makeup remover, which is by Clinique. If you're looking for a really affordable, very effective waterproof makeup, eye makeup remover, doesn't have to be waterproof makeup, then I recommend this one. If you're not cruelty free, I'm sorry, I'm like stuttering and fumbling on my words. I haven't done a video in like 2 weeks. Actually, it's been 3 weeks now, so okay, we're getting back into it. The next skincare product is the Pixie Skin Treats Peel and Polish Resurfacing Concentrate. This is a face scrub. It says that you can use this 2 to 3 times per week. You have to apply this on clean and dry skin. I feel like it works best on dry skin anyway. Maybe with a little bit of water to really help it move around the face. You leave it on for 2 minutes to let the natural enzymes like eat away at your dead skin cells. Or for extra polishing, you can gently massage, which is what I do because I don't want to leave it on my face. I actually like the scrubby action. And then you rinse it off and pat dry. So what I do is I always cleanse my face in a shower, and then at the sink I will use a scrub. So normally with any other scrub, I don't do that. I scrub first and then cleanse, so this is in the shower. But with this one, because I like to use it on dry-ish or dampish skin, I use it at the sink. I feel like it really makes my skin so smooth and really helps to bring up whiteheads so I can pop the crap out of them. The day after, because I use that in conjunction with a mask, the day after my face looks so clear and smooth. The next skincare product is the Kula. Okay, I'm not even gonna tell you the whole name of it. You know why? Because I've mentioned this so many times. I mentioned this in every favorites video. I don't know. I can't get away from it. I'm not that type of person anymore that talks about like every new product on the market. I'm just not like that. And I don't want to be like that. And I'm never gonna be like that, especially because I want to go more eco-friendly. I refuse to buy so many products, but I do love to try out new ones, but one at a time. So this is my favorite face sunscreen of all time so far, and my husband likes it too. He just hates applying sunscreen, or like any sunscreen at all. I mean, who does? But this is definitely our favorite. It just makes your skin so matte and so silky, but it's a great makeup primer. I do use the primer. I'm just saying, like, if you didn't want to use a primer, you could still use it, and it doesn't make your makeup slip and slide, even though it makes your skin feel very slick. Actually, not slick, that's not the right word. It feels very like powdery and smooth, but oh my gosh, if you are looking for a natural sunscreen, this is gonna be the one for you, especially if you have oily skin. It is SPF 30. If you aren't comfortable with lower SPFs, maybe this one might not be for you. I don't know if they have one that has a higher SPF, but this one's just perfect for me. And I haven't gotten a tan. Like, I don't think I got a tan at all, even though Europe had quite a heat wave and I was going out every day. All right, let's talk about this confusing favorite. No, it's not a favorite. It's a confusing one. It could actually be an unfavorite, but I don't want to say that because, well, maybe it's not a favorite. I just don't really like it. This is a Shea Moisture Matcha Green Tea and Probiotics Transforming Clay to Cream Cleanser with Milk Thistle. I don't know how I feel about this at all. It looks like it would be a clay mask. I don't really know how I feel about it because when I first was using it, it was at the hotel that we stayed at when I first flew here because it was so freaking hot. I do have a vlog on that, by the way. And I feel like it made my skin feel so clean but dry at the same time. But then I was like, it can't just be this because the environment, you know, with the heat and then the AC in the hotel, it was like drying out my skin. And we've stayed at his mom's house quite a few times already. And going to Amsterdam, we also used this exclusively. I don't know, my face didn't break out, but I felt like it was breaking out when I was using this. I don't think it breaks me out at all. I just don't know how I feel about it. I wouldn't repurchase it, so maybe that's the answer. I think it's a nice cleanser. I just don't think that it's like a wow cleanser, something that I would buy again. Moving on to the body care products. Oh, this I'm definitely gonna repurchase in a full size when I get back home. This is the Pixie Body Treats Glycolic Body Lotion. I mentioned this in both of my body care videos that I did before I came to Germany. I love it because it's been keeping my acne at bay and really helping to smooth and moisturize the body all at the same time. I can't believe they took so long to come out with something like this. I'm not saying they like Pixie. I do like Pixie, but Pixie is more of a newer brand to me, so I was just waiting for somebody to come out with something like this, and this is the answer to my prayers. I think I mentioned like 2 months ago that I think this would only last you for a month with daily use, but it's actually been lasting me for quite a long time, and I've been using this literally every single day. I use that after every single shower. It works even better when you use a scrub. Speaking of scrub, this is the Frank Body A Beauty Scrub. Again, I did show this in a video, only when I was here though. I don't remember when I showed it, but this is such a good coffee scrub. It just makes your skin so freaking soft, and I just especially love to use this on my back. I look forward to the 2 to 3 times a week I use this because it just keeps my skin on my back so clear and smooth. I still do have acne there. I will probably never not have acne, but this just really helps to keep it clear, keep it smooth, and it actually does get rid of those bumps that you feel like when you run your hands along your back and you just want to like scratch them off, which sometimes I do, but it's not that good for you. This really helps with that. And you guys know this is my favorite coffee scrub company brand thing of all time. I will talk more about how I want to be more eco-friendly with my things. I probably will still repurchase from them because they're just that good. But eventually when I start to make my own soaps, my exfoliating bar soaps, I will probably put these coffee scrubs in those bars. This has been my favorite self-tanner for the past 2 months or the whole summer. I don't use it when the weather drops like 10 to 20 degrees here in Europe. I use it when I check the weather report and it's about to be like close to 80 or 80 plus, and I'm gonna wear, you know, things like this, shorts, and I really like it. I mean, it smells so bad, but it works so fast and it works so well. You can definitely layer on more every single night. There's no transfer on clothes or bed sheets. You just put it on after a shower, you know, you do your whole exfoliation thing, you apply it, and within 5 minutes of letting it dry on your body naked, you're tan, man. I tell you, you're tan pretty much instantly. I do have a video on my self-tanning routine, so I'll link that in the description box. This is another body favorite. This is the Raw Sugar Simply Body Wash. This is lemon sugar. I also mentioned this in my skincare bag video. This is a really nice, simple body wash. It just smells like lemon heads, and that's why I really enjoyed using it. Lastly, for body care are my two sunscreen favorites. This is Sunbum SPF 50 Broad Spectrum. This is the Australian Gold SPF 70. Sunbum was our sunscreen pick all last summer, and this one is the one that I mentioned many times already on my video for this summer. I miss this so much because it just makes your skin feel so smooth and it's non-greasy. So if you have drier skin, don't use this. Get the Sunbum one. But if you have more oily skin or you just don't like that greasy feel, Australian Gold. So good. This is the other confusing product for me. This is Frank Body Body Balm. I did talk about this, I think, in one of my last videos. There was an oil explosion in my skincare bag when we landed in Amsterdam. I was wondering why my skincare bag was so oily. I think whoever handled my suitcase was not very nice because the cap to our mix of oils for our face was open and there was no more oil in that bottle. Was all over the place. So the only other oil I had packed was the Frank Body Body Balm. Even though it says it's for the body, you can use this on the hair, you can use it on your face, you can use it for your hands, your nails, but I wasn't sure if I wanted to put it on my face because it is a body balm, but I didn't want to use it all over my face. But the reason I use an oil in my skincare is because I just think that they're amazing for the skin. They have a lot of antioxidants, they have a lot of nutrients, you know, things like that. And that's my husband's sole moisturizer. He doesn't actually use a cream or a lotion. So I decided to take a risk and use it all over my face. And it was so nice, but my face was kind of breaking out like crazy. But I wasn't sure if it was this or because of all of the temperature changes. At that time when we went to Amsterdam, it was really hot. That was the week of the heat wave. And my husband was saying, maybe it's the body balm. We stopped using it when we came back. And then I made our mix of oils when we got back to the apartment. And our faces felt so good, like so much better. But I don't know, I can't really say that my face cleared up because of that. But I think maybe it did. I don't know. So I'm so confused. As for the body, I do really enjoy using it. It's very moisturizing. It's actually not greasy. It's not greasy despite the fact that it's really oily and it smells delicious. It smells basically like their coffee scrub. Okay, so now on to fashion favorites. I have two. One is the shoes. I bought these shoes in Germany at a store called Deichmann. I bought these shoes because I didn't prepare at all for European weather. So I was totally prepared, overly prepared for the heat wave, right? So I have a pair of canvas sneakers by Keds and there's a hole in it and I didn't want to wear those. And it was getting pretty cold at some point when I got here, so I decided to pick up these slip-on shoes. I showed this in my summer essentials video, so if you would like to see them on me, definitely go to that video after this one. I never gravitated toward this style of shoes because I wouldn't say I'm not opposed to loafers, but it wasn't part of my wardrobe until I think like last year or 2 years ago. So when I saw these there and I tried them on, they were really nice. I do not wear them with my socks. I just slipped them on and they're great. They fit perfectly. They don't hurt my feet and they go with all of my outfits. And I wanted to buy another pair just because I saw a really cute neutral colored one. And this is the pink pair. So they're very pale pink. These actually got used way more than the black ones. I'm so surprised. Like with this shirt, I would probably wear this as well. I never thought of myself as like buying something that wasn't black or nude, but I was proven wrong. The next fashion favorites are my bras. I actually completely ditched traditional bras. I think I did mention this in a previous video, and that's because I have such small boobs already that I don't really care about wearing bras that help support them. I think it's mostly to either fill out tops or to hide my nipples. I have really been loving sticky bras or stick-on bras. This one and the one that I'm wearing are from a lingerie store here called Hunkemöller. This one cost me like $40 and it's only because of the string part here. So this is a bra that I wasn't ever gonna get because I don't need that cleavage. I just want lift. And no, this doesn't work. Don't be fooled by ads that show you, you know, the lift and the cleavage and stuff. The cleavage probably yes, but the lift no. If you have bigger tatas than I do, stick-on bras are not really gonna be your best friends because they're not supportive. I just love using these because they just, I don't know, they look great, right? I will show you the nude one that I picked up. I actually picked it up yesterday and I'm trying it out for the first time now. This is a nude one that comes with a different front here. So this is just a clasp that you unclasp and you know, you rip off like that. I was so afraid that I would have had to buy the same style but in nude because I don't really like this. And you can actually see the strings here if you're not wearing the right shirt. But most of my shirts work with my stick-on bra, so it doesn't really matter. It looks kind of crooked because I did it all wrong. I mean, I don't really care. They're just so comfortable and they're so goddamn sticky that I just don't ever worry about them falling off and looking really weird. The reason I bought this one is because my favorite and first ever stick-on bra broke. So the cups are fine. I actually did wear this under a bodysuit a couple days ago and was totally fine. My boobs didn't look weird. But it's just that the clasp is made out of plastic and I have no idea how it just busted open under my bodysuit. So I guess I was getting my money's worth out of it because I was wearing it nonstop. I wore these nonstop last year too. So same thing, it comes with a clasp in the front and you just stick them on your boobies, clasp them, that's about it. As for lifestyle favorites, I've had a smoothie almost every single day since I got here. And yeah, I basically have been creating a lot of waste in this world because I buy my smoothies, okay? I don't care much for making my own smoothies when I'm here. I buy them. So I've been buying them from Fruiters and from Immigrun, which are two of the smoothie places that they have here that are chains. I don't really have a preference for smoothies. If I feel like I'm in a green mood, I get a green one. If I feel like I'm in a fruitier mood, I'll get a fruity one. The next lifestyle favorite is on Netflix and it is Brooklyn Nine-Nine. It took me a long time to watch that and I love Andy Samberg from SNL. And I don't remember ever seeing that he ever had a series on NBC. It's really funny, but it's not like laugh my ass off funny. You know, some of the characters are like bleh, but most of them are really funny. The next lifestyle favorite is Amsterdam. We really loved Amsterdam. It's one of the most beautiful places I have ever seen in my entire life. I will have those vlogs coming up. I just haven't really been motivated to do a lot of things for YouTube. I do have travel diaries on my channel and I want to share my experiences with you guys as well. So this is a reusable cup. This is my next lifestyle favorite. This is a reusable cup that I bought at the hotel that we were staying at. We were staying at the Westcord Fashion Hotel and they had this right on the counter in the lobby. So right when you go up to the front desk, it's right there. It cost 10 euros and it was great. It went with us everywhere for the whole week that we were there for. And I just filled it up with tap water. I'm kind of arrogant, I guess. I don't like to drink from the tap. I know New York City has like really clean tap water, but I don't know. So anyways, I just got off my high horse and just filled this up with their tap water in the hotel in the sink and it was fine. It tasted fine. Wasn't weird. I find New York tap water tastes kind of weird. So what makes this bottle really cool is that it has this rubber part at the top so that your water doesn't leak all over the place. It does make the bottle really heavy because the bottle is actually pretty weighty already and it's empty, but it was just something that we needed since the heat wave over there was ridiculous. We didn't fill it all the way though because I stupidly decided to carry around my little Primark purse or handbag instead of my Kipling one that is practical, and it wouldn't fit in there. So my husband actually put this in his shorts pocket. Isn't that great? I just love reusable water bottles now. I only use it for water though. I don't put anything else in there, like no smoothies or anything. I just don't want to like contaminate the bottle and everything. So last lifestyle favorite, protein bars. This is my protein bar stash. And yeah, it's a lot. And it's just weird because I actually crave protein bars now. I just wanted to try them because every time we go to DM, which is a drugstore here in Germany, I always see them and I always want to try it again. So when I was in middle school, I used to buy power bars all the time because they were so good. They were so chewy, so flavorful. They're not like the protein bars that they have now that are like vegan and all that stuff that tastes like dirt. They taste amazing. And I did buy a lot of power bars. So I like to have them after my workouts, before my shower. And if I don't finish it before my shower, then I'll finish it while I'm doing my skincare. So when I take off my makeup after my workout, I eat it, and then I take a shower, and then I eat it. It helps to curb my appetite because my metabolism is crazy. So after my workout, I'm like starving and I need to eat something right now. It helps to keep me a little bit satiated while I make dinner or we go out and get dinner. My favorite power bar is the chocolate brownie flavor. But if I wanted something like nuts, so I wanted my protein from nuts, I would just eat one of these. This one is in salty peanut crunch and this one is in strawberry and cranberry. I like to try different ones. The only ones I stay away from are the ones that have white chocolate. Also the ones that have coconut, I don't like that. I find all these to be delicious. However, I did find kind of like a dupe for the power bars and it's the DM brand, so you can only get them here in Germany. This is Sportness. When it says Eiweiß here, it is egg white. So they tell you the percentage of egg white that's in here. This is 32% and this one is 50%. I tried the one in strawberry, which I don't know why I didn't pick up. I guess I just wanted to try different ones because these are the ones I haven't tried yet. It is so good and it tastes a lot like the Power Bar. So Power Bar and the DM brand bars, they don't leave that weird protein bar aftertaste in your mouth that I freaking hate. This one is, I think, less than a dollar or less than a euro, and the Power Bars are over a euro. Oh, I have an unfavorite. This is the Kristen S, the One Signature Conditioner. I shared this with you in my, what's in my travel makeup? No, skincare bag, and I freaking hate this. Like, I hate it so much. It leaves my hair feeling so dirty, like there's a film on it, and I can't rinse it out no matter how hard I try. And the smell of that line is so perfumed and it's just too strong. I hate that. I don't even think flies like to fly around my head when I use that conditioner because it smells so freaking bad. Because every other conditioner, every other shampoo that I use, they like to fly around my head. So that's saying something. Okay, let's go on to the empties really quickly. I know this video is pretty long, but hey, I'm back after 3 weeks. So this is the empty of the Australian Gold SPF 70 sunscreen. I would repurchase this again, but probably not anytime soon because the sunbum one is still full and I will be leaving Germany very soon. So here's to another 3 months of never leaving the house again. This is the DM Danto Dent. This is an alcohol-free mouthwash. This is not the one that we like. They just don't sell it in a travel size. This is what we picked up before we went to Amsterdam. We actually really like this. I probably will pick it up again the next time we go travel. This is the Weleda, what is granat apfolican? Oh, pomegranate regenerating oil. This is a regenerating body oil. I actually tried to use this on my face the first time I got it because I was stupid enough to not realize that it's not for the face. I don't know what it is about putting body oils on the face for me. This I didn't really like because it was too fragranced, too perfumed. I just don't like that. I just like 100% cold pressed oils and it didn't really moisturize my body anyway. This is the DM Balea body lotion. This is just a regular body lotion. My husband flew through this body lotion because he is such a big man and he used this during our week at the hotel when I first got here. So there is nothing left in here. He won't get that again though because it's just not moisturizing enough for him. We also actually finished our Kula sunscreen. This is another one, if you're wondering. $30 well spent every single time. This is the Alcina Skin Manager AHA Effect Tonic. So this is our glycolic acid toner. This is another one. We just bought another one. So the one that we've been using after this one is already almost gone. So we bought another one. Clearly, we love this. The last empty is the La Roche-Posay Lipicar HP Plus Body Oil Wash. This is what happens when the writing is in German and I'm trying to tell you in English like what it is, but I don't know the name of it. This, I am so freaking happy that we used up because I hated the smell of it. It smells like plastic, melted plastic or something like that. I freaking hate it. My husband actually likes it, but I don't. And I won't buy it again because it smells. In terms of a body oil wash, I wouldn't say it was like the most moisturizing, but it's definitely more moisturizing than your traditional body wash. And if you do have problematic skin that's really dry, maybe you have KP, you know, keratosis pilaris or something, eczema, this is actually really nice. I did buy this in a set. I think I mentioned this in our Oberhausen mall trip. I bought that with the Lipicar AP Plus body lotion, which we still have. I don't know, very expensive products, but this one I don't like. Let me know in the comments what your favorites, unfavorites, confused about things, empties were for this month, or anything you want to say to me. As long as it's nice, obviously. Subscribe to see more videos. I will have videos up now twice a week instead of three, just because I'm scaling back on my stuff. I mentioned why in my last video. It's a video about my channel update, my life update, and I will link it in the description box, or you can catch it in my end screen after this video. I will also link my last favorites video in the end screen, and you can watch either one next.